Hi everybody, this is Alexander, and I'm going to talk about balancing system in my MTB game simulator. The first thing we learned to do when riding a bike for the first time is to keep balance. By itself, the task of maintaining balance is solved at the level of reflexes and often remains incomprehensible to our consciousness. The solution of this problem is so hidden from our mind that after a few days on the bike, we begin to think that in order to go straight, you just need to pedal, and the bike will not fall by itself. Let's try this approach in the simulator MTB game demo. To do this, we disable the balancing system and try to ride on a flat asphalt playground. As you can see, the first attempt was failed. Perhaps the second time will be lucky. No, not the second, probably the third. In fact, how many times we would not try to go straight without a balancing system, we will never succeed. Let's try to reduce the speed of the simulation in half. Obviously, failure again. Go ahead and reduce the speed 4 times. It's already possible to travel much further, but there is still not much time left for the reaction. Only by slowing down the simulation speed by 8 times, it is possible to somehow get to the end of the asphalt playground. In this case, our ride in accelerated playback looks like we drunk fell before riding. Here are the main things that we figured out with the balancing system turned off. The bike always falls on its side if nothing is done. If we turn the handlebar to the right, then the bike falls to the left side. If we turn the handlebar to the left, then on the right side. To go straight, you need to constantly turn the handlebar in the direction of the fall. The human vision system is too imprecise and slow to solve the problem of balancing. Even with a simulation that was slowed down 8 times, it couldn't quickly recognize the fall and send a signal to the hands to turn the handlebar in order to move quite smoothly. Now turn on the balancing system and see how it copes with the same task. The bike rides perfectly straight, while handlebar oscillations are even imperceptible. To make them noticeable, you need to reduce the speed to very low like this. As well as the balancing system copes, a rider reflexively copes with steering without involving the brain. The hands and the vestibular apparatus receive the weakest signals of weakening the pressure on the handlebar or the deviations of the position, and the muscles react as they were trained. In addition, it helps us in steering that the front wheel axis doesn't intersect with the axis of the headset, but is brought forward slightly, and the axis of the headset is inclined relative to the up vector. This leads to the fact that when the bike is tilted to the side, the wheel tends to turn itself in the same direction, making a kind of automatic steering. Due to this effect, a bike without a rider can travel a considerable distance without falling under certain circumstances. Also due to this, you can ride without holding the handlebar, controlling handlebar's turnings by slightly tilting the bike. But after all, we can turn with the bicycle by turning a handlebar and the bicycle doesn't fall anywhere. In fact, this is true and not true in the same time. Try to focus on riding and watch carefully before the next turn, so as not to make any additional actions, but simply turn the handlebar in the direction of the turn. You are unlikely to fall, but also you will not be able to turn to where it was intended. The fact is that any turn on a bike consists of 2 phases, the tilt of the center of mass of the rider bike system and the subsequent walk of the handlebar to maintain this tilt. To tilt the bike, we turn the handlebar in the direction opposite to the turn. Usually we do it unconsciously. We just press down and forward on the internal grip. After that, the bike begins to fall inward, and in order to stop the fall, we turn the handlebar to the side we need and balance it, maintaining the desired tilt until the bike turns. Finally, we return the bike to the upright position by briefly turning the handlebar to to an even greater angle. The balancing system in the MTB game demo performs all the reflex muscle work, determining the necessary angle of turn of the handlebar to tilt the bike depending on the speed and steepness of the turn, maintaining balance in the turn and returning to the vertical position. The balancing system will work even if you make a small mistake in the bike control or land it with a turned handlebar. But you need to understand that the balancing system has a limit due to the limited grip on the wheels and the speed of the arm muscles necessary for handlebar turning. This is all you need to know about the automatic balancing of the bike in the MTB game demo. Good luck to your riding, enjoy the trails, and let the artificial intelligence to do all the routine work of maintaining balance.